Hey guys, in this video we will write a system of equations to solve a problem involving investments. The problem is going to give us some information about the investments, and it's going to ask us how much is invested at each rate. You'll have two different accounts that you're working with. The first sentence tells us the total invested, and it also gives us the two different accounts. Part is going to be invested in the 13% account, and the rest will be in a 6% account. So those are our two accounts. We're going to think about invested dollars for our first equation. So we're going to think about the invested dollars in the 13% account. We're going to call those dollars X. And then whatever amount is invested in the 6% account, we're going to call that Y. So part of the $12,833 is invested in the 13% account, which is X. The other part is invested in the 6% account, which is Y. And the total invested was $12,833. That gives us our first equation. X plus Y equals $12,833. That's only invested dollars. Now let's take a look at the interest. The problem says that the interest earned from the amount invested at 13% exceeds the interest earned from the amount invested at 6% by $830.77. So we're going to write a second equation that addresses these interest dollars, which is different from the invested dollars. We have the interest in the 13% account, so we're going to put a 13% or a 0.13 on the X, and we also have interest in the 6% account. We'll write that as a decimal, 0.06Y. So we've got interest earned in the 13% account, 0.13X. We're going to subtract the interest earned in the 6% account, 0.06y, and the reason we're doing that is the word exceeds. One account exceeds the other account, so that's going to be a difference equation. And then the difference between those two accounts is $830.77. So our second equation is 0.13x minus 0.06y equals 830.77. We now have a system of equations. We have an invested dollars equation, X plus Y equals $12,833 invested dollars. We also have an interest equation. The 13% account exceeds the 6% account by $830.77. I'm going to first fix the decimals on the second equation to make that a little easier to work with. And my suggestion for that is just multiplying by 100, which allows you to move the decimal two places to the right in each of those numbers. So that new equation will be 13x minus 6y equals 83,077. It's a big number, but we can handle it. Then I'm going to write my two equations again. My first equation is my invested dollars equation. My adjusted second equation doesn't have any decimals in it, and I'm going to use addition method to solve this. So the first thing I'm going to do is make some opposites. I'm going to choose the x's just because they're out in front, and I'm going to take my coefficients off the x's, the 1 and the 13, and I'm going to swap those out in front of the parentheses. The X terms both have the same sign, so I'm going to just drop a negative on that 13 so that I have an opposite. I want my X's to be opposites after I multiply these values in. So the first equation, if I multiply by negative 13, I will get negative 13X minus 13Y equals negative 166,829. The second equation, I'm just multiplying by 1, so it doesn't change. It will be 13x minus 6y equals 83,077. When I add the two equations together, my x terms eliminate, which is what I wanted. I have negative 13y minus 6y, which is negative 19y. And then I have negative 166,829 plus 83,077, and that gives me negative 83,752. I'm going to divide by that negative 19 on both sides. And when I divide the negative 83,752 by a negative 19, I'm going to get y is equal to 4,408. And that is actually what has been invested in the 6% account because I allowed y to represent that account. I can plug that amount in anywhere I want. I'm going to pull the original invested dollars equation and I'm going to put 4408 in for y in that equation. And then I'm going to subtract the 4408 from both sides and find that x is equal to 8,425. And that is the amount that was invested in the 13% account. So this is how I would approach and solve this problem. I wish you luck as you attempt more of just like these.